I am building a shipping container house. The two containers in the front will be carved out to be the front porch with six columns in the front. People ask me what I do with the wall panels that I cut out. Well, they're sitting here in a pile. My plan is to use these panels to build five single car garages right among the trees without cutting the big trees down. So to find out how I would build them, I did a practice run and I built a shed out of the wall panels. Let me show you how I did that. I get a bolt, thread through that, and pull these two together. What I've done is to put some braces at the corners and on top. I think this stabilizes the whole thing really well. Piece of cake. Okay. Thank you.
7/16 and 11 millimeter are the same, I guess. So what I'm doing here is actually to put a stopgap piece between this 2x4 on the inside resting right on the metal beam and another piece of 2x4 that's pressure treated. It's going to be right on the outside. So what I've done here is to put a strip of 1.5 by 1.5 pressure treated lumber here, and that is going to be sandwiched between this 2x4 and another 2x4, which is pressure treated, that I'm going to put on next. If I don't do it, then there's a gap between the two pieces of 2x4 because the shipping container walls are corrugated. So the pressure treated 2x4 is coming up next. So what I have here is basically the setup for the roof trusses to sit on, and what I've done is to basically use 2x4s to sandwich the corrugated container walls in the middle, and there's this strip that is pressure treated as well. This is pressure treated and this is just regular lumber, and so this is what the roof trusses will be sitting on, and it's pretty darn robust. So I thought I did a great job with this concrete threshold, but well, it turns out I didn't take into consideration of how it should line up with the frame for the door. So I am going to work on that right now and put some concrete in there and water it, and that should work. I haven't seen anybody doing this. Maybe somebody's doing this, but I haven't seen it on YouTube. But for the top edge of the shed roof, I am going to basically use this to cap it, like what I've done there. And I think that is going to stop the rain from going anywhere inside. Done. That's it.
I'm done, man.